is that rely on yourself, you know, rely on yourself to make the impact of the world, but don't change, you know, don't, there's no need to change, what we call the people that aren't willing to change, but willing to change, you know.
Yeah.
Those people will come along eventually, you know, like, yes, okay, and that reminds me, what I was going with that is like, kind of like my family. You know, always wanted this high respect for my family and everything, you know.
And but it might never happen.
Yeah, it may never happen. People may never be pleased with the thing that I decide to do.
I feel the same about my family.
Yeah, but we're doing the best we can from our hearts.
That's right, and our souls.
Yeah, right on the nose. That's
without regards to what other people think about it, you know. We do what's right, and we spread the word the best we can. And we try to trust the universe to to let the word go out and assimilate itself. Our truth we teach, we try to trust the universe to bring it to the proper people at the proper time.
Just like this. This is words of the infinite. Okay. I'm not saying it just like the infinite. Trust me. But you know, just like me and Matt, he was saying, if you only knew what you were doing to help the world, you know, if each and every one of you knew, you know, what you could do to help the world, you know, be it love, helping, healing, making, you know, things better. If you knew what you were capable of as an individual, you know, you could change the world.
More than the world. You change the galaxy, the universe, actually. It just goes more than that, even, right? You can do everything. You can do it all.
Well, the
world is what people would understand better, I think. It's kind of hard for some people to imagine other planets and other races of beings.
That's what the Buddha was saying. Like, y'all, remember, y'all are different.
Krishna said that. Remember, you're different.
Earlier, John Lennon said something like that about us being different. I didn't comment on that, but he said, y'all are very different, you know, different people. And almost in a kind of condescending way, you know, but he didn't mean it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm proud to be different. I don't care. You know, I know we're not normal people here.
Oh, no.
We're not normal humans. And we're far from it. We're probably not even human all the way. We're probably hybrids, really, more. We call ourselves hybrids. You know, but, you know, I know I am. You know, but we're a hybrid between extraterrestrial, spiritual, and human. So.
Yeah, like, we're not doing it like. We're just doing it out of the goodness of our hearts. We have no reason to do it otherwise, you know?
That's right.
You know?
Like, it reminds me of a guy last night. Let me speak on this. Like, it reminds me. I didn't mean to interrupt. But
okay.
I had a guy, at a friend request from a guy in England who's a psychic over there. And I was explaining to him, like, look, you know, like, we're on our last lifetime, our last physical lifetime. I was like, and you can do it too. He's like, I don't think I can learn all this stuff in one life and this and that. And, like, that kind of let me know. I don't know that he wasn't fully aware of this stuff. But, yeah, I said, yeah, you can make this your last life. All you got to do is learn a few lessons about infinite love and about the truth of this stuff, but what's really going on behind the scenes. And that way you don't have to keep coming back. And y'all can do this, too. You know.
Exactly.
Jeremy and I have been through tens, thousands of lives, physical lives, and believe me, when you get sick of it, when you get to the point where you're disgusted of living day to day, and it's not just because of money, it's because you're aware of the world and the problems and all that, you're very near the end of your evolution and physical lives. You know, once you get to that point where all you want to do is kind of get out of this world, you know, And you're aware spiritually, but you know, not like you want to kill yourself, but like you're like, damn, I'm tired of keep coming here. You know, I'd rather live elsewhere, another higher dimension. When you reach that point, I think you're pretty close to your graduation. How do you say that? That's my feeling.
Yeah, like, you know, and so many people, you know, rely on money to think that that's going to change
everything.
It's not going to change everything. It's not going to just
do the time shift.
Yeah, it's, you know, one thing I learned that, you know,
money does not change everything.
No, I mean, it might help. And there's lots of things that you can consider help. You know, you can get help. But the idea behind help and the word help is for you to decide to make it better. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Money is just help. You know?
Yeah, we're not sitting here worried about money. We're not sitting here plotting and planning about how we're going to get $1 million or how we're going to do this or that. The money, yeah, we would like to have some money, you know, it'll come, you know, it'll help make life easier with our bills, but we're worried about doing what we love first, and we're trying to change the world, and, you know, we're trying to make life easier for you all and help you all become great spiritual teachers as well, and we're here to raise the vibration level up on this world to higher levels, and to spread knowledge, truth, and wisdom, and beauty, and love, and that's our work, you know? We're here to instruct you all, and to turn you all on. We're here, we have the power to switch all you guys on, if you wish to be, to switch your minds on, to understand higher truths. That's what my goal is.
And we're doing it.
And we're doing it.
Yeah.
And that's happening.
We're doing it.
We're here to turn you all on. We're not here to be like this lone spiritual teacher or the lone spiritual master. We're here to create spiritual masters. And all y'all can be spiritual masters walking the streets or some song came to mind about walking the streets or something. I don't know what it was. But
Jesus was chiming through, man.
All right, go ahead.
Lord Christ or Lord Jesus will say. He was just saying, you know, a minute ago, I could hear coming through, you know, like, well, you know, try being in the shoes of myself as a human being. I just walked. I just told the truth. I just, you know, tried to tell people they were forgiven through my father, all this, and he was, you know, killed.
Yep.
You know, now, there was no drive behind it, except for, you know, he was doing what he felt, you know, it was right.
That's right.
Do what's good in your heart.
That's right.
You know,
regardless of the consequences.
You know, maybe we don't walk around outside, you know, and we're not in little groups of people. We're not in little groups of people that, you know, can criticize us right away. You know, we have to do it worldwide. We don't want the criticism. You know, we're not here to take the criticism or be against the criticism. We're just here to help.
That's right. Yeah. You know, but you can imagine people probably bitching about that, you know, saying that, oh, well, you guys are devils, you're demons, and I even see people saying that about you.
Like
him,
like Christ.
Yeah, same way I said to Christ, you know, like, you're demons, you're against God, you're a devil, you know, you're deceiving people from the true path, and, well, it's just that's the last thing we're doing. Like, y'all are the ones who've been deceived by a lot of these false religious teachings that are out there. You know, I'm not trying to be judgmental, but y'all are out there that have been deceived and lied to through government, through false religion and false teachings. Y'all the ones that need to wake up, look in your heart. Don't depend on any church or anything like that. Depend on yourself.
Lord Jesus says that something about the clothes on his back did not make the clothes on his back special. Fact that he walked the earth did not make it special. You know,
keep going.
That he was born did not make him special. What made him special was what was in him.
That's right.
You know, what was in him, what he wanted to accomplish himself. You know, for each of us to accomplish, you know, and it's back to myself, each of us should accomplish this in ourselves. I see what he's saying. It's in ourselves.
It's in each and every one of us, and you and me and everyone. You all have the same power. Y'all could be doing everything Christ did and more, and everything Lord Buddha did and more, everything Lord Krishna did and more, everything. There's nothing you can't do.
Nothing you can do that can't be done.
That's right. We're going to pick right back up in just a second. We are on the 20-minute limit here. We're 1952. I will be right back, y'all. Peace. Peace.